Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So I am here with a flip through for you of my Hobonichi cousin. Yes, my Hobonichi cousin. I put up a video a couple of days ago explaining where I have been, why I haven't been on YouTube, which is kind of self-explanatory, but where I've been gone, etc. And I mentioned that I had changed my planner set up completely during this lockdown, and I have. This is my main, you can call it an everyday carry, but I'm not going anywhere, but it's my main planner. So it is a Hobonichi cousin. I have it in a Hobonichi cover. I cannot remember the color name, I'm sorry. I just picked like the pink one on the website. I bought it from Amazon Japan, and it just, like, I just picked the pink one. But it has the cover on cover as well over the top, and then I just put in this piece of acetate, which is from the Honeybee shop, which says Stay Spooky. And then I have a sticker here that says Shenanigans inside, which is from Shameless Sticker Co. And it is just a vinyl. And then this is a, if you'll be able to see, this is a little Slytherin sticker. It's metal. It's quite thick. Yeah. And so that's my cover. So I have a lot of stuff. You can see it's quite stuffed in here. I have a Sharpie permanent marker, which is what I use to write on Sweet Kawaii Design stickers. And I have one of my Lamy fountain pens with pink ink, which I use to journal if I can't just, like, I use lots of different fountain pens. I have lots. But that's the one that I'm currently using the past couple of days. So that stays in there. So we open her up. And I'm not done decorating. I don't think I'm ever going to be done decorating, because at first I was being like, ooh, this coordinates, this matches, make it look like it matches. And then I decided to just say, fuck it, excuse my language, but I did. And I'm just going to stick stuff in here that I like, that brings me joy, that makes me happy to see it. Oh, by the way, excuse my Peppa Pig plaster. And my lack of wedding rings. Not getting divorced. Lockdown's not been that bad. But all the hand washing, and I also have OCD, which makes my hand washing worse. I have got a blister right where my wedding ring sits, and it's really sore. So I've taken them off and put a plaster over it. Try and let it heal before I wear them again. But yeah, I decided to just say fuck it and stick everything down if I liked it. So I've got some die cuts here. I don't know where they're from. I had them a really long time. This die cut is Once More With Love. This one is Honeybee Shop. I think that's Fox and Pip. This is a sticker my son made for me in his sticker machine when he first got it. I haven't stuck it to anything. I just put it in every planner I have. That's Once More With Love. This little washi card, I'm not sure where the washi card's from. I can't remember. And the sticker pocket on the top that says Planner Stash is from the Coffee Monster Co. And then I have a few little stickers in there. This is the back of a sticker, just to sort of see how cute that is. And then I have some random samplers from Once More With Love. It's just tucked in. This I had on my computer for like 12 years. I love these guys. I can't remember. Jeff Thomas, I think. It says you're so hardcore. Hello, I'm emo. In here, I have this happy scrappy pocket, which I have some stickers. There's some samplers. There's some new stickers that I want to use in here. There's some checklists. And then some most used. So Kawaii TV from Fantasy Design Stores. My D&D stickers, which were way too small, but they work for me. Once More With Love YouTube. I have a bunch of Willow Wallico ones, which are all new as well. And some random samplers that I want to use. And these boxes from Miscellany Boulevard that I have had for years, which fit really well in the Cousins Weekly pages. So they're all in there. It's my random, if I need a sticker, check there first. This washi, no idea where that's from. Oh, I do. It's from, no, I don't. The card and the acetate as well. It's either Planners Anonymous or Mummy Lay. I think it's Planners Anonymous. No, GP Studio. It could be GP Studio. I don't know. But this acetate has like the phases of the moon. I just like the colors. This, I can't remember where this is from either. I'm really good at this, aren't I? It's laminated, I just stuck it on. Once More With Love. This is the from Josephine Beau Designs. It was Rachel's PR freebie sticker. It's different now, but that's what it was. Fox and Pip, Willa Walla Co. And this one's from Redbubble, but it's for ACOTAR. I was gonna do sort of an ACOTAR theme, but instead I just, like I say, stuck down what I liked. And like, this is a good example. This sticker came, and normally I would have put it in a box and saved it and, you know, never used it because I wasn't sure what to do with it. Or I would have laminated it so I could use it a million times. I just stuck it in. Stuck it on there. Who cares? On the other side, I have a postcard which says, "Be bold and brave in your heart." I can't remember where that's from. Some more die cuts. Bitches Love stickers. Again, don't know where that's from. Nap Queen, I'll have to check. I bought a whole bunch of die cuts from different shops. I will double check where they're from and I will leave all the shops linked below. Paper clip that says, "Okayest Mum Ever." And Number One Mum, because I'm their number one mum, but I'm not the number one mum in the world. This was in the Once More With Love anniversary box. The sticker, it's a cloud planner. I bought a cloud planner. I sold the cloud planner. I didn't really, it just wasn't me. I like A5 size, but I didn't want an A5 planner. I wanted bigger, but I didn't want ring. I don't know what I was doing, but I bought it and it just didn't work for me. But I like the sticker. Then the other side, I'm a ray of fucking sunshine. That is from, what's she called? It's not Lights Planner Action. Sunshine sticker, maybe? I'll have to check again. That's quite old though. This one says, "Different doesn't mean wrong." I purposely stuck it this way around because of what it says. I feel like it works. This one, "Don't be so hard on yourself. The mum in ET had an alien living in our house for days and didn't even notice." That's me. This one, I really want to say it's Blossom Nose Co. I'm going to double check. But my friend Becky, when she set up her cousin, and I totally blame her, by the way, for this entire purchase. Like, everything. I blame Becky. It's all her fault. But I am also super grateful to her because, holy crap, this is close to planner piece for me. But she had some die cuts from this shop. I'm sure it's Blossom Paper Co. or Blossom Nose Co. And I bought this one. And then like 2 days later, Becky had a different flip through and it was in there. I was trying so hard not to just buy the same things as you, Becky, but I failed. This is Coffee Monster Co. Bellum? From an... Oh, that's ancient, but I don't know when that's from. These are both Redbubble and they're ACOTAR stickers. Okay, so we're in the yearly at a glance. So this is this year, this is next year, and this is last year. These stickers are from Josephine Beau Designs. I have them right here because I only just got them. You get the 2019 stickers, but I don't know if I want to use them because, like, I'm not going to reference back to what day of the week a certain day was in 2019. And if I am, I'm gonna look in my phone calendar, I'm gonna be honest. In fact, I probably rarely look at this. So I might put like a sticker, a whole sticker there. I'm not sure yet, I haven't decided. But I put these in because they're pretty. And we all need a bit of pretty. And they're sparkly, foily. And I have highlighted birthdays. Like family, immediate family birthdays. The family in this house, their birthdays. And my brother. I've highlighted family birthdays on here. Then there's this. I don't know what to do with this. So I haven't done anything with it. Apart from when it comes to 2021, I'm using it as a key. So I'm only going to use this as a planner for the rest of the year. You can use it. It goes up to March of next year. I am not going to because it's already fat. and I don't think I'm going to be able to. So I've already decided next year I want to get the Avec, where it's 6 months in each book. So I'm just going to use this up to the end of the year. So this I'm using for different lists. You see, and I have set up a key here so I know what lists are where. Then we're into the months. So the months started in February. I didn't get this planner until April. So I back planned. I bought these sticker kits from Shine Sticker Studio because I was watching Emmy Lou Arts. I'll link her down below. New favourite channel, by the way. She is hysterical. But when I was started using my cousin, I searched for people on YouTube who were planning in a cousin. And she was, and she bought the sticker kits, the monthly EC sticker kits from Shine Sticker Studio, and did some sticker cutting to fit them in, and it works really well. So I bought the February and the April. I think actually I bought more than that. February, April and May. I didn't like the March one, so I didn't buy the March one. But I back planned, just put in some important, the important dates. And then I also did the same for March, but I used a Coffee Monster Co kit. I didn't like it as much as the Shine Sticker Studio. I feel like this covers and is brighter colours. This is a bit too muted, I think. But I used this, again, I back planned. This is when we have been home since the 17th of March. So I back planned all of that. And then we're into April. Absolutely nothing happening because we were on lockdown. May, nothing happening because we're on lockdown. So it's May 11th today, by the way, that I'm filming this, and we are in Scotland still under stay at home lockdown, don't go anywhere unless you have to, sort of thing, for another 3 weeks probably, and probably longer. And quite honestly, I'm glad I'm not going anywhere. So I'm not sure what to put in though in my monthly spread. Like, I put dates of stuff happening, like our Asda deliveries and our bins and Easter and Greg's birthday, but I don't know if I want to put anything else in. I haven't decided yet if I'm going to put anything else in. I might, but I don't know what. So if anyone has any suggestions. So I haven't planned the rest. I've written in here in pencil, 12 weeks are up, because that will mark 12 weeks since we went into self-isolation, and my husband is in a high-risk group. So in the UK, high-risk groups had to self-isolate for 12, well, had to isolate at home for 12 weeks. So part of our lockdown, I'm allowed to go out to get our groceries once a week. Technically, we're allowed out for exercise, but where we live, we don't need to, so we don't. Like, we don't go for walks around the area or anything. But we're allowed to go out. He's not working. He's furloughed. But you're allowed to go to work if you're a key worker. Food and essentials, which is what I'm allowed to do. But because he's in a high-risk group, he's not supposed to do that either. He's supposed to just stay at home for 12 weeks. So that will mark when he's been at home for 12 weeks. That's the only thing I've written in. Stuck some post-it notes in. And then that is the end of the months. So, I have top tabbed it. Can you see my pretty top tabs? You can't because of my super cute kitty cat Leia. But I've top tabbed it. The tabs are from Josephine Bow Designs as well. I love her tabs. I've top tabbed the weekly section, and I have side tabbed the daily section with two different sets of tabs, because I love tabs. Who doesn't? So we started the calendar, the weeks in April, and because I'm only using it to December, I have done April to December, which is why it's a bit messed up at the end. And we go straight in. So this was the first week. I actually got this planner here on that day, the 30th of March. So this is my first week, so I was just trying stuff out. I used a Happy Scrappy kit. So yeah, and it was a bit weird. I was getting used to it. Then I used a Coffee Monsters Co. kit. I marked up at the top. So the black number is the number of days we've been lockdown, and the pink is the number of the days that Scotland has been under lockdown, stay home, whatever you want to call it. I don't know what to call it. I hate saying lockdown. It's not quarantine because we're not quarantined. I go to Tesco's, but we'll call it lockdown for the purposes of this video. Yeah, so the black is for us, the pink is for the UK. Yeah, so I sort of forward plan, but I don't really need to forward plan anything. Things like I put in the Easter Sunday sticker and stuff like that, but like nap, I put in what we do. So the nap, I made cookies and they weren't nice. I cleaned the kitchen, folded the laundry and did my nails and watched YouTube. So that stuff that happened, and I put that, what I watched that night and that sort of thing, but not really, like it's not forward planning as such. I'll put in the delivery and I put in that I had to call Tesco's for my insurance, but other stuff isn't after the fact stuff. So you can see there's loads of Marvel Universe stickers as well. During lockdown, I decided to watch all of the Marvel films because I'd never seen them. I'd only seen Black Panther and Captain Marvel. Hadn't seen any others. I've now watched them all. It broke me. Totally broke me. Had a lot of movie nights. And then this sticker is from Stationery Wonderland, and I absolutely love her. I've got a haul coming up which has the mystery kit for the month from her in, and I love them. The stickers are really good quality and they are purposely made to fit the cousin, which is really nice. I really like that. And I actually had the washi that matched the kit, so I could use that. This one is from Some Little Things. This is actually a Hobonichi Weeks kit from my subscription, which I was trying out. So it sort of fits. The date covers are a bit odd because they're side on and there's a space for the number, but I didn't cover up the number. I'm not sure if I like that, but I just wanted to see if I could use the Weeks kit and how it would work. And I think it works quite well because I took these off the other kit. I didn't mind the washi that came with it, and I just feel like it worked. It actually worked really well. So you don't need an EC size kit. I feel like it can make a Hobonichi Weeks kit fit. And this one, is this last week? Yeah, it's last week. This is a Sweet Quiet Designs kit. This is in the itty bitty size, so the date covers fit perfectly. The boxes are perfect because they're small, so they don't take up the whole row, which I really like. The only thing, the picture ones, the full boxes, are really teeny, but I feel like it actually looks really good. And this is the washi, I cut it up. I didn't have enough. The reason I stuck that there is because it stopped like here, the washi, but I still think it works really well. I really like it and I'm really happy with it, and I think I'm gonna, well, I've subscribed to the mystery or the quiet, I can't remember, one of them. She does two. I've subscribed to one of them. So yeah, I really like it. I think it works. And I just like to use a bunch of stickers, to be honest. And this is this week. So I feel like I'm getting into a sort of, I know what I'm doing with this one. So it's less of a forward planning, more of a back planning. Like I put some things like Judith's birthday, that's my sister-in-law, I put that in before the week started. And I'll just show you actually, next week, there's nothing except bin day. I've planned the whole month already because I just like using the stickers. This kit is an EC sized kit and I cut down the date covers. I've had this kit for years and I wanted to use it really badly. But you can see I've only put in the bin and some other stuff. And that's it for the weeklies. So then, after the weekly section, I have tipped in some vellum and card, which are both from Happy Scrappy, an old subscription. That sticker is from Redbubble. Again, that's ACOTAR. This one is from Blossom Nose Co. And so are these stickers, which are just some weekend size stickers, bin day and recycling, and the Out of Fuck sticker because I liked it. And I just put them in there so that they're easily reached. I know they're there. I haven't actually used any of them because they're new, but I know they're there. So then we're into the first month. We're into April. There's a page at the beginning of every month which is blank. And in April, I thought, I know I'll use it for lists of things that I'm going to get done. Because we're in lockdown. I'm going to be at home. I'm going to have loads of time to get stuff done, which is total crap. You can tell I've done nothing. So then we are into the daily pages. Daily pages look like this, literally a daily page. It has a time section here. You could use this as like a daily planner, but I'm using it as daily journaling. So I journal at the end of the day. I'm going to flip through real quick because I haven't covered anything up. And you don't need to read that. There's some days where I didn't write anything. I just stuck a bunch of washi and some pictures. But I printed off pictures from my Sprocket. This is when I got my Stationery Wonderland order. I made Mars bar slices. I have made them a lot while we've been in lockdown. And most of the stickers that you see, I have used from my Happy Planner sticker books. And from my junk journal sticker books. I had a flare. I had a fibro flare this whole weekend and my journal spread turned out ace. So these I printed off with my Paper Ang printer. These are Happy Planner, Paper Ang printer, Happy Planner. Do you know what? This book, the journaling bit of this book, I just stick stuff in. I draw stuff. I stick stickers, random stickers. If to keep it sort of consistent, there are some days where I've taken one sticker book. So like I take one sticker book and take the stickers from here over the 2 days to try and keep some sort of consistency with the colours and things, but otherwise, I've just been going for it. And I've been using my fountain pens, and I've just been enjoying it. And I stuck in a post-it note there. Washi. This is where I use some acrylic paint, watered down, and then stickers on top. And then I got into my water paint. Watercolours. I remembered I had watercolours. That's actually a picture stuck on top of another picture because something happened to the colour. It all ran. But I went a bit mad with my watercolours because I found them and used them. I'm not going to turn that over because I did write some stuff there. But you can see, like, I watercoloured. I made a mess. And I used foldy-over stickers if there's stuff I want to write that I don't necessarily want to see. I need to write it. I need to talk about it. I need to get it out, but I don't want to see it. So I put it in there. I forgot to explain this page marker. This is from Stationery Wonderland Co. Wonderland Co? Stationery Wonderland Co? Or just Stationery Wonderland? Hello. Just Stationery Wonderland. Yeah. This is from Stationery Wonderland. It is the cousin-sized page divider. I love it. While I was waiting for it, I tried to make my own. You can tell. It didn't come out too well. I actually used too thick a laminate, I think. And I laminated it twice because I made a mistake the first time and it just made a mess. But I use this one to mark my week, this one to mark my day. And I print pictures off on my Sprocket, stick them in. I've watercolored some pages, so you can tell I'm a bit behind. Today is the 11th, so I'm a bit behind in my journaling. But I've already done some watercolor here for the 20th because I wanted to try out this pigment powder that I got from UK, that I got from Little Rainbow Moon. And so I just did it on a random page. And when I get to that page, I'll journal over the top of it. Doesn't matter. That's what I'm loving. The watercolors, I just get them out. I wax that. Like all these pages that are watercolored, I did before. I didn't do it on the day I was journaling. I spent one evening sticking a buttload of watercolors down. I talked so much, my camera turned off. We have tabbed all the way to December with my Josephine Beau designs tabs. And then in January, this page marker is also from Stationery Wonderland. It's the calm your tits, Foxy. You can't see it here. There we go. See, it says calm your tits. It's the calm your tits, Foxy. I love her. And this is where I'm doing like collections, like you would do in a bullet journal. So I literally just stuck a bunch of washi down, did the worst hand lettering ever with my mild liner. And it's a planner wish list. My first planner wish list was for a smoke and rose gold Twisby fountain pen, which I bought. So I've written got it next to it with the happy cat, which is from the Ginger Cat Company. Then the next page is my general wish list of things I would like for my house. This is blossom paper or something, I think. I can't remember. And that's Sweet Kawaii Designs and that's Shine Sticker Studio, but they're for Michael's washi tape. And that's what I'm going to do here. It's just some random lists. So I've done that in January because I'm not going to use this as my planner next year because, I mean, it's already, it's hard to tell, but I'm going to try. Look, it's quite fat. I mean, it's fat. It's chunky. This is like a month and a week, if that, of another month. So I don't think it's going to survive if I use it for the whole time it's allowed. So I'm not going to use it after December. I am planning on getting the Avec. I actually thought last month, like I was tabbing it, which was only, a week ago maybe, I think it was, when I was doing all these tabs, I thought maybe I should just go up to July and then buy the Avec for this year. But that felt like such a waste. Like, this felt like such a waste. Still wondering if I should. But I don't want to. I want to try and use this for the whole year. At least the remainder of the year. I haven't stuck any stickers here yet. I'm gonna. I just haven't done it yet. I've got a lot. I just haven't stuck them in. This I took out of a ring planner that I had set up. Because I love it. This is me with my mum and dad. That's me when I was little with my mum and dad. Which, scarily, I look like my mum now. Greg looks like my dad. And Posey looks like me. Like, if we dressed up like that, we could recreate it. But I just love that picture. So I keep that here in the back. Then I have some random flags. A card from my friend Robin and a card from my cousin that I keep here because I like it. And this is a bookmark from Akatar, which I was thinking about sticking there, but haven't done yet. So it literally just tucks in there. And that's it. That's my huge, oh, I've got a key ring stuck here that says to the stars who listen and the dreams that are answered, which is from Akatar as well. Because like I say, that's what it was gonna be, Akatar themed, but it's not really anymore. But that's it. That's my current planner. That's it. This video is really long. But that's my current planner flip. For now. The planner won't change, but the stickers, etc. Well, like, I'm going to put something here. Maybe washi or a bit of card or something. And I've got loads more stickers that I want to stick in. Loads more stuff that I want to write in. And honestly, I just like using stickers. You can tell I just like to use stickers. So I'm just going to use stickers. I'm going to use stickers as much as I want to, as often as I want to. And I'm going to sticker it up. I might not have to pre-plan a lot because we're home, but I can sticker it up anyway, which I'm going to. And that's it. That's all. I will try and find links to everything and leave them down below. If anyone has any questions, please leave them down below. Or you can find me on Instagram. I'll put my Instagram name just here. I don't post very often over there, but I should start getting into that again, I think. But I'm always there in my DMs if anybody needs anything or wants to chat or anything. And yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching, everybody. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.